Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. Well, I'm indoors because today is not a good day to go outside and film anything RC. Do you remember yesterday I was outside and showing you all the snow that had fallen? It was beautiful, it was sunny, it was great. And today, well, check it out. Today it is rain, and it's melted all the snow because it's very, very warm. So I'm indoors for a review and the product I'm going to show you today is right here. This is the Toolkit RC-MC8. Yes, I know, it is rather tiny and you're wondering, what the heck is this little thing? Well, let me show you. Opening the box, you can see our product inside. This product is for people in the RC hobby. Looking at the bottom of the box, you can see I have a USB-A to USB-A connector cable right here, and that's gonna be for firmware updates or even charging items. I'll show you that in a second. Then you get some instructions right here, an instruction manual. Next, on the very bottom of the box, I'm not going to take it out, but it's a screen protector for your device. Now, if you're somebody who flies camera drones, you know, from DJI, Hopsin, Autel, well, then this device means nothing to you and you'll never use it. But if you're in the RC hobby, let's say you have an RC car, an RC truck, an RC plane, an RC helicopter, an RC boat, an RC drone, you know, like an FPV drone, you see me flying them all the time where you put the goggles on, then this product is something you need. So let me show you all the inputs on this product. So starting on the bottom, we have an XT60 connector, and then if we go to one of the sides, we have a balance connector for a 2-cell all the way up to an 8-cell battery. Then we have another connector that is going to be used for your servos or your receivers, just to check them to make sure they work. And on the very top, you have two ports. One can be used for firmware updates, or you can use them both for charging devices like your cell phone or anything that's USB-C or USB-A. And then if I go to the side, I have a scroll wheel that you can push in to select different menu options and a slider option. They call it a throttle control. And that's pretty much it. There's an awful lot in this little unit. And now, since many of you are scratching your head, let me show you what you can do with it. All right, so I've got a battery here. So if you're in the RC hobby, you have batteries like this or like this. You know, you have batteries for all your items, and you just buy any battery you want, any size you want. So say I wanted to check the voltage on this battery. Well, you could be out in the field. I'm out at the field flying a drone, or I can be out with my RC car or boat, and I just plug this in the bottom, and I can tell if my battery is good because it tells me right there what the voltage is right on the screen. Now, say I'm out at the field and my battery is kind of wonky and the cells aren't balanced, and I also want to check what are the cells. Well, you can put from a 2S to an 8S battery in here. This is a 6-cell, by the way. So I'm gonna plug that into the side, and on the front here, I'm gonna see what the voltage is for each of my cells. And not only that, as the voltage for each of the cells is being displayed, this here little unit is balancing them. So it's moving some power from one cell to another so they're all equal, so that when you go drive your boat, drive your helicopter, drive your car, drive your FPV drone or whatever, you're getting full performance out of your battery. Next, I'll bring you over to the side where it's pretty cool. You can check out your servos or your receivers. So here I have a servo that goes in one of my RC cars, a big RC car. And I wanna make sure it works. And not only do I wanna make sure it works, I just want to check how much power I can put into it. So let me just get the wiring correct here. It says put negative on the bottom. There we go. So now to make this work, I need a power source. So I'm just gonna plug in a 2-cell battery down here at the bottom. And there we go, we're all good. Well, I have a little scroll wheel here and I'm gonna scroll it over to PMW. So I'll select that, I should hear a beep. And now I have a slider control on the side, and look at that, I can move my little servo and I can check it out. You can do that with any servo of any voltage. It will work all the way up to like, if it takes 8S power, just plug in 8S power to get it to work. Now, I don't have any receivers. Normally, if you fly RC planes, helicopters, FPV drones, or whatever, you have a little tiny receiver, and that's how your radio communicates with the receiver and the drone or the helicopter or whatever. I don't have any because they're all in my drones all over the place. I don't have a spare one, but if I did, it's the same idea. You just plug it in the side. You put it on the next one over here. That was PMW, which would be S-Bus for most new receivers, but you could also put it back on PMW, I believe. Most of my receivers are all S-Bus. And then what you do is you plug your receiver in the side, you take your radio, if you've already bound to that receiver, then as you move your throttle sticks and everything on your radio, you will see everything move on here and it will tell you that it's good. If you have a bad channel, it will show you the bad channel. All right, so let's hop out of that. What else is there? So I did that. Oh, the charging. So here, let me just plug in a cable on the top here. And there we go. I'm putting it in a USB-A cable on the top. And let me just plug in any old battery down here. Well, I'll put in the 2-cell again. There we are. And then let me take one of my cell phones here and plug this in the bottom, and I'm going to charge it up. So if I'm out in the field and I need power in my cell phone, this will charge it up. There we go. So it charges it up. You can do that with anything that takes a USB input at the bottom. Just charge it up just by running it off of any battery you have. So of course, that means for any of you that have camera drones, if you have a camera drone that the batteries charge up via USB power, then you just plug, have a big battery like this, if that's the hobby you're into as well. And then you have this and you plug your little USB cable into that and then the other end into the battery or the charging unit, and you charge up your camera drone batteries. All right, and other things you need to know. If I look at the bottom, it says the input for power you can put into it is 7 volts DC all the way up to 35 volts DC. So that's pretty decent. I don't have anything that's 35 volts, but I'd need an 8 cell for that pretty much. So as you can see, it's very versatile for the RC hobby, and it's not very expensive. And the more important thing about this, it's tiny. You throw it in your pocket or you throw it in your RC hobby bag that you take to the field with you. So it's a pretty neat little product. It's the only one of its kind that I think does all of this as well as it does all of this in a very small, inexpensive unit. So I'll put links to it below if there's a discount code. I don't know because I haven't checked where this is sold yet. But when I find out where this is sold, if I can find a spot with a discount code, the discount code will be below so you can save some dollars on the purchase of this product. All right, guys, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, and feel sorry for me because I'm stuck inside because it's a rainy day. Catch you in the next video. Bye.